Hey guys, crazy freaking idea of a video. It's been a long time since I've actually put up anything whatsoever. I don't think I've put up anything. So, apologies for that straight away. As you can see down the title down below, as usual, this thesis in my TNPL squad. So, TNPL just concluded. I didn't put up any kind of predictions because I was baffled this year around because I was expecting two to win, as usual. I don't think anyone else wanted two to win. I was expecting people, that doesn't mean I was supporting the Patriots team. Obviously, they were the better team on paper. You got Sundar, Dinesh Karthik, Abhiram Mukund, Ashwin Kreis, also Srinivas, all brilliant people, anyone. Lots of people have played for the TN, they played for, they represent the IPL team. But the sad thing is, not a lot of the IPL stars could actually make it big. I think only two people really made it big. One was Washington Sundar, obviously, and the other one was our friend Jagdeesan. Jagdeesan maybe spent 3 or 4 days at an RCB camp because they lost KL Rahul. So if you remember, Vishnu Vinod was the guy who came in, but Jagdeesan was in line for recall. He was there. Him and Vishnu Vinod tried out, and I think Vishnu Vinod got it. So anyway, here's my squad, and let's get to the openers. Arun Karthik, the opener for Madurai. Things will be told about him in the following part. And Washington Sundar, obviously, to the Patriots' is best opener. As you saw in the previous part, you got Arun Karthik and Washington Sundar. I'm going to put Sundar as my non-striker because I personally like Arun Karthik because he's a guy who goes from ball one. And regardless whether he's confident, he's not confident, he's not in form, he's in form, he doesn't get it, he's going to go for the slog. And I don't think a lot of people really knew about him, but I think he first made the scene during, made the spotlight during a CLT20 edition for RCB. I think it was 6 of 1 ball or something, and he chased it down for them against some quality lineup of Sean Tate, and I think it was a red back, South Australian red back. So that was a brilliant game he put up, and so Arun Karthik made the scene. At the same time, he has a wonderful strike rate this season, 178.6. I mean, obviously Madurai is a terrible team. They haven't done anything. If you look at the previous two points table totals from last year and this year, it gives you 1 point. And that too this year because they got a rainwash game. So when you're playing some 16 games and you get only 1 point, the team is terrible. But I think there's only so much a person, and he has done a lot for the team, and that's important. So Arun Karthik's there. And then the other one is Washington Sundar. I don't think I need to explain anything. I think that immense confidence he would have got from playing for RPS would be enough. And that's what he's exactly come here and shown. Didn't do much in the finals. But I think the rest of the league, rest of the stages summed it up for, made up for that final. But I guess you should have won the finals. But hey, I'm not complaining. Shea Pop won. Baba Aparjit, captain of the VB Tiruvallur Veerans. In at one, this is a contrasting decision. I put in Aparjit. I could have essentially put in someone like Bharat Shankar, but I've decided to go with experience and Aparjit. Aparjit was brilliant. If you think about it, a lot of the leading run scorers were openers, so I had to choose two of the best, and I chose the best and one of my favorites, Arun Karthik. Aparjit, on the other hand, was especially aggressive this year, so I hope it doesn't collide with his exceptional Ranji Trophy form. He's a brilliant test player, and I don't want to. He's a wonderful, he has got the perfect defense that I've seen apart from Chiteshwar Pujara and Dravid. So he's one of a kind. So hopefully he doesn't get an aggressive mindset and doesn't do well in the Ranji season. But anyway, he was wonderful this year. I think he scored 285 or 258. Both brilliant scores. And I think he would have made, I think his team could have made it in if it wasn't some terrible umpiring by, I don't know which, I'm not calling out names for the umpire, but terrible umpiring. Clear no ball, I mean, not a no ball, but gave the no ball and made him lose the one of the important spots for the playoffs.
Akshay Srinivasan from Laika Kovai Kings.
Srinivasan is really a big star, and I think I watched maybe 3 matches he played, and he's got that range power as well. He's gonna clear the boundary. At the same time, he also played a wonderful anchor innings. I think there was one match against Trichy, that last match of the league stage. I think they were struggling when Surya Prakash and Anirudh Sitaram got out. They needed someone to anchor the innings. And when Trichy were especially bowling well. And I think
Srinivasan did very well. Even though he scored some 30 odd, it's still enough. And the same match against Veerans, when Vijay got out after that onslaught, they needed someone to guide. They needed someone to stay with Anirudh Sitaram, and that was the guy. Akshay Srinivasan was there for them. The next, I'm putting in my wiki, R. Rohit. Fastest TNPL done, but that's not the only reason I took him. The Karikuri is not really summed up his how he played in the league, but still he was beautiful. He didn't get a lot of other scores, but he was perfect behind the wickets, and he actually collected a lot of those weirdish deliveries that you get. I mean, that's a weird team, that Kovai team. You got Vignesh, Harish Kumar, Sivakumar, MK Sivakumar. They're all weird. They don't always stick to the same line. They're gonna get drastically. And there was one thing he did well. There was a ball that was drastically outside the legs. Some dive, then he caught the ball. So, good wicketkeeper. I don't think any other wicketkeeper is that good except Dinesh Karthik. And I don't want to put Dinesh Karthik in my IPL team as well as my TNPL team. Let's go more for the youngsters this time around. And that's what I've done.
Captain of the CSG, Chepauk Super Glees, Rajagopal Satish.
There's no specific reason I have Satish in my team. I just want to have him in my team because he was the captain of the winning team. And I guess I could have gone, but there were no better middle order options I could go for. I mean, clearly, I'm contradicting my decision when I said go for the youngsters. And this guy's a 30-year-old grandpa. I don't think I should be putting in my team. But I think he cleared the boundaries a lot of times. And he's a very good slow hitter. At the same time, if the pitch slows down, as it has drastically done throughout the tournament, Satish has got the right decision to come out, and he's given himself the chance to bowl. That's wonderful, and that's what you need to do as a captain. Take audacious decisions, and he's done that. And I mean, if you look at his run-up, he has a run-up, and he bowls slower than Sai Kishore, who's a spinner. Sai Kishore bowled at the higher 90s. He bowled in the lower 80s. That's Satish. But I think you need Satish in the team, and he's going to be captaining myself. Whence he lost his Anthony Das, the last person to sum up my middle order, perfect all-rounder, great hitting. He didn't do well like he did last year with the ball, but he's made up for that with the batting, and I think I need a very good finisher to end things for me.
Mr. Consistent, R. Sai Kishore, leading wicket taker for this season.
Sai Kishore, leading wicket taker, Mr. Consistent, one of my favorite players for this season, and I think someone who's going to come to this team this season. If he puts his name in the auction, he's confirmed going here or any other IPL team. That's my bet. Then I've got three people to finish it off. Chandrasekhar Ganapathi or Ganpa, the Karikudi Kale fast bowler. The only bowler from Karikudi Kale to actually make an impact. And he's played for CSK for a season or so. And he's bowled very well. Higher 130s and made the batsmen really struggle. Then to finish, then I have two more people. One is Vignesh Kannan from Ruby Trichy. The guy you may probably know as. That's how he celebrates, and he bowled very well. He's not taking wickets, but he's been clogging up runs, an essential factor for T20, which is eventually build up pressure and take wickets. And finally, to end with, I've got Adisaya Raj Davidson for TT Patriots, the fast bowler who clogged higher 140s, took 4 wickets in the 11 in the qualifier 2, no, in the first qualifier, and he's done well throughout the tournament. Anyway, that's my spot for this season. Change what? Comment down below if you have any changes, and I'll see you next time. See ya.